It's not just the hack that's causing problems for Uber, it's the cover-up. The loss of personal data of 57 million customers and drivers worldwide is bad enough. But the company took extreme measures to cover it up for more than a year, and that will cause huge problems. The company's new chief executive officer, Dara Khosrowshahi, who only took over in September, has said in a statement, "None of this should have happened, and I will not make excuses for it. We are changing the way we do business." It was October 2016 that hackers pulled names, email addresses and phone numbers of 50 million Uber users worldwide. The personal information of 7 million drivers was taken as well. But the company insists no credit card information, social security numbers or trip location details were stolen. The company had a legal obligation to report the hack to regulators and tell drivers their license numbers were taken. But it didn't do that. Instead, it paid a $100,000 ransom to keep the hack quiet.
No doubt that recent news is great ammunition for people who oppose Uber. It's also probably quite good news for Uber's competitors, so companies like Lyft and other ride-sharing companies. It's not clear that Uber will be able to survive if it continues down this line of corporate culture and mismanagement. They have many incentives to make sure that these issues don't happen again.
British regulators are looking into the breach and the Attorney General in New York has launched his own investigation. It's not the first time Uber has run into problems. In March this year, the founder was recorded arguing with one of his own drivers. He later apologised. More than 20 people were fired after an investigation into sexual harassment at the company. In London, the first steps have been taken to ban the company outright because of what was described as reckless behaviour. And on Tuesday, the company was fined almost $9 million in Colorado, after investigators found it was employing 57 drivers who either had failed or should have failed criminal background checks.
There were violent offenders in there, and there were also people whose license had been revoked because of DUI, and they were letting those people drive anyway, and they knew it.
Uber is a worldwide company valued at around $69 billion. It's now facing massive new fines and a series of civil suits from those hit by this latest breach. Alan Fisher, Al Jazeera.